So the next thing that I want to talk to you about is the processing fee. Remember that I mentioned in the previous video that no one is going to sit there and use their computer and electricity and time and effort to process all these transactions to make sure that you have that money to send to me, I have that money to send to John, and can keep going back in history looking in the blockchain, the public ledger, to make sure that each person has that money before they can send it. Well, remember in the old days, in the legacy bank system or the 1% bank system, the system that only benefits 1% of the population, what happens is they charge you a fee. So there is going to be a fee, right? But over here, what happens is anybody over here, only the people that work at the banks can process the bank transactions. Here, because it's a public ledger, Satoshi did something that was very brilliant. He wanted to, or she wanted to make sure that no one can destroy this system, this protocol, this system, this network. See, because you can go drop a bomb on one of these banks right here and the bank would be gone. Or the government can come in and shut it down, it'll be gone, right? Look at what happened to some of the big institutions like Lehman Brothers, they're gone, right? Bear Stearns, gone, right? So what happens is Satoshi was very concerned that if this works, that the guys that are in power over here is going to come try to destroy it, right? He was really concerned about that, or she was really concerned about that, okay? So Satoshi just stayed up, and said, you know what? If I try to centralize this into one place to where only a small group of people or a small handful of people have control over this entire network, this blockchain, and manage this public ledger, right? It's going to be a problem because as honest as that person is going to be or that group of people are going to be, if the people from the 1% here don't like it, they're going to come and destroy it because these people got more money and they got bigger guns, okay? So what Satoshi did was very, very brilliant. Satoshi created this blockchain and he or she announced that anybody can come and volunteer to process all these transactions, okay? So if you want to volunteer your computer to come in and process these transactions to make sure that I have that dollar to send to John and that John has that dollar to send to Obama, well then, if you do that, what's gonna happen is this. Let me just show you what it looks like. Over here in this banking system is here, it's central here, that's why it's called the central bank, right? In every country it's called the central bank. In America we call it the Federal Reserve, but that's just the fancy name that we gave it, right? So that it makes people think that it's part of the government agency, but it's not, okay? The federal, the name Federal Reserve is no different than the name Federal Express. It's not anything that has to do with anybody in the government, okay? It's just a company that makes money by printing money for these banks and issues money, okay? So what happens is this. This is centralized so that only these 1%, the central bank and the affiliate banks underneath it, can benefit. Over here, this entire system is a lot different. It's called a decentralization, meaning that there's no one person or one organization or one company that controls it or one government. It's the 99% that's of the population on this planet controls it, right? So everybody has a say-so in it. And what happens is if you are willing to volunteer your computer, your electricity, and your hardware, and your software, and everything to process these transactions, you get rewarded for that, and that reward is similar to the bank transaction fee for sending the money, except here it's going to be for processing the payments. So what happens is this payment, initially when Satoshi invented this entire Bitcoin system, it started back in, I'm just going to make a timeline here so that you guys understand it, okay? So what happened was Satoshi made it back in 2009. And I'm going to draw a timeline here, all right? So what happened was Satoshi said, hey, if you're willing to volunteer, anybody, if you're willing to jump in and help to build the system and volunteer to process all these transactions, what you will be rewarded is 50 bitcoins for helping out. And BTC is the symbol for bitcoins, okay? It is the symbol for bitcoins. It's the shortcut, like in the US dollar, the symbol for the US dollar is USD, and the symbol for the Japanese yen is YEN, and things like that. Well, the symbol for Bitcoin is BTC. So now you know the symbol for it. So whenever you see BTC, you'll know that means Bitcoin. So initially, Satoshi said, hey, if you are willing to volunteer and come in and help us process all these payments and these transactions that's going on from people sending money back and forth and buying different stuff, you will be rewarded 50 Bitcoins for your efforts and your time and your computer and to help compensate for your electricity and everything, right? And what happens is that remember I mentioned in the previous video that every 10 minutes, a new block that includes all the transactions in the world are in here. And it's been verified. Like somebody actually went back in history and said, hey, you know, this guy has this much money, this guy has not enough money, whatever. And they compiled it, everything, and they submit it to the entire network, and everybody gets to view it and check it, okay? And if it is correct, then that person gets 50 Bitcoins, okay? Now, you might say, okay, why does it take so long? Why does it take 10 minutes to confirm these transactions, okay? Well, it does not take 10 minutes. It takes 10 minutes, around 10 minutes to confirm it. However, it only takes instantly, as about the speed that you would send an email, to propagate the entire network. In other words, there are, let's just say that there are just a bunch of people out there with computers, okay? Just sitting around doing nothing, and all they're doing is they're waiting for Bitcoin transactions to come through. So what happens is all these people right here with their computers, they're willing to volunteer their time and their computers to process this payment. So out of these thousands and thousands of people around the world, and you might even at this point, by the time you see this video, it might even be millions of people, okay, around the world. When they process these payments, whoever gets the next block correct, right? So if we have all these blocks done, whoever is the first person to get the next block of information correct to fill in the blockchain, right? That person, let's just say that it's this person right here that gets it correct first. Well, what happens is that person submits it, and all these other people can see it with their computers, and their computers will go in and check it immediately to make sure that it's correct before it gets added here. So if this person finishes all the block, completes the processing of all the transactions in this block, this person will get rewarded this 50 Bitcoins right here, which is quite a bit of money, okay? And at the time that it was 50 Bitcoins, the Bitcoins were worth like $30, $40, $50, $10, whatever. Even if it's $10, that's still $500 for this person's time and effort to process all the transactions that you and I and John and Obama are using and all the businesses around the world. So no longer is the banks getting the fees, the transaction fees, it's these people right here, these processors, okay? Now, what happens is, every 10 minutes, only one of these thousands of processors get that reward, okay? And here's a caveat here, okay? Is that every 4 years, okay? So 2009, now it's 2013 while I'm making this video, this drops down to 25 Bitcoins, okay? And then in another 4 years, 2017, it drops down to 12.5 Bitcoins, and it keeps getting halved and half and half and half until there is no more, until it's just a little minuscule, okay? So it's negligible. We're not even gonna talk about it because it's so small, okay? Now by doing this, by the year 2040 or somewhere around there, there will be a total of 21 million Bitcoins created, okay? That's it. 21 million Bitcoins to ever be created. And you know, if you keep cutting something in half and half and half and half, it's gonna get smaller and smaller and smaller. So we say 21 million, but there might be just a little bit over 21 million, okay? don't freak out on that, okay? Just go with the big number of 21 million because that's easier to calculate and easier to understand, all right? So this person right here that figures out what the next block of transactions is, gets that reward. Either right now, as I'm making this video, people are only getting 25 Bitcoins. I first heard about Bitcoins when it was still 50 at the beginning of the year, but then by the time I actually invested and bought some Bitcoins, it was down to 25 Bitcoins for each block of information.